Thank you. let's sing it just one more time tonight. Amen. And just go ahead and lift your hands and just give him praise and glory tonight. Just magnify his wonderful name. Oh, I say, oh, hallelujah. How I love Jesus, oh, hallelujah. How I love Jesus, because he first, oh, Lord, aren't you glad he loved you tonight? Amen. He loved you enough tonight to be so wonderful. Mighty God we serve, oh, to me, hallelujah,
he is so wonderful.
What a wonderful friend we have tonight,
to me,
glory, glory,
he is so wonderful, shalala mokora bala kishara laka, because he first
the Lord a good hand of a praise tonight and bless his holy name. Hallelujah. He's worthy, church. He's worthy. He's worthy tonight of our love. He's worthy tonight. Woo! Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah to the great I am tonight. Amen. Amen. Thank you, guys. Thank y'all. Great job. And amazing love tonight. Amen. Amazing love. Praise the Lord. Sister Shannon, on your way back, could you talk to my son? Catch him, if you would, please. Amen. You may be seated tonight. Praise God. Praise God. I just want to say a special thank you for coming out tonight to the house of love. Josh, where are you run off to, friend? I'm getting a lot of echo up here. Got a lot of feedback. Thank you for coming out on a Wednesday night. Being in the house of the Lord, we know we've got several that's sick and under the weather tonight. We want to keep them in our prayers and the faithfulness of God upon their lives, that he will touch them, he will strengthen them and keep them mightily. Amen. If you got your Bibles tonight, the book of 1 John, the fourth chapter. 1 John, the fourth chapter tonight. Praise the Lord. I want us to enjoy the word tonight, but just to let you know, I'm not totally an old Scrooge. I just want to let you know. So I want to preach the word. I want us to have some fellowship afterwards tonight. So thanks to our WMs. That's a good job, guys. Good job. Good job. Woo! Thanks to our WMs. They have went out and purchased some cookies and some punch tonight. And so there's some fellowshipping going to go on out front tonight. So when we dismiss here, we get to go outside and just have a little love fest tonight. Amen. So I'm not such an old Scrooge after all. Amen. They even bought some pretty pink plates and pretty napkins, if that says anything. It says I didn't have a thing to do with it. But I want you to know I love you, church. Amen. Amen. Tina Turner said this statement, "What's love got to do with it?" It's got everything to do with it, amen. I don't know what society she came from, but I tell you, you hold in your hand tonight a book of love tonight, amen. You hold in your possession tonight, you have in your heart tonight a God of love who loves you, who died for you, who gave his life for you tonight, that you might be an overcomer by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of your testimony tonight, amen. God loves you. He loves you abundantly tonight. Praise be to God. Lord, love you for being here. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we love you tonight. Lord, we just thank you for the holy word, Lord, that we hold in our hands. Lord, that we write up on the tablet of our heart tonight. Father, I thank that it was written, Lord, by the Holy Ghost. Lord, it was written with the finger of God. Lord, it's been established. Lord, it's been proven. Lord, and it has been tested and it has been tried. And Lord, you said heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall never pass. Lord, you said my word shall never pass. Lord, and it will accomplish the thing whereunto I sent it. Lord, and it will not return void. Father, I thank you tonight for the holy word of God tonight. Lord, that it will bless. Lord, that it will heal. Lord, that it will deliver. Lord, it will set free tonight. Father, we thank you for the message of hope. Lord, and we thank you for the message of love. Lord, that it brings tonight, Lord, to our hearts and to our lives. Father, just anoint the listener, anoint the messenger. Father, we love you and we give you all the praise for it in Jesus' mighty, mighty, mighty name. And everybody said amen. The 1 John, the 4th chapter. 1 John, the 4th chapter. I'll pick it up in verse number 7. 1 John 4 and verse 7. Beloved, let us love one another. Woo, that's a strong statement tonight, folks. Let us love one another tonight. He said, if you love the Lord with all your heart, body, mind, soul, spirit, strength, and love your neighbor as yourself, you just kept all the commandments all wrapped up in one. These are the greatest commandments, that we love God and we love one another tonight, because he said, for love is of God. So if you don't know God, you ain't got love. Amen. You may have a form of it, you may have a fashion of it tonight, but tonight, because God is love. All who lives in God, ever who lives in love lives in God. All who lives in God lives in love. Amen. We get the true fashion of it tonight. And he said, everyone that loveth is born of God. It's a born again experience where you start experiencing what a fervent love is all about. So in order for us to, when we become born again, then we start experiencing that agape kind of love. We move from the filial, kind of love, which is the brotherly love tonight. That's why the name Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love. That's where it comes from, filial. Filial means brotherly love. But God takes us from filial love to a place called agape kind of love. And that is God's love toward us tonight. So we have a born-again experience tonight. When we born again, become regenerated, we get his love on the inside of us tonight, and we start releasing that to people. And he said, one that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. Aren't you glad you know love tonight? Aren't you glad you know the God of, whew, my Lord, it's Holy Ghost good. Just you know the giver of love. You know the one who loves you, and you just can't get enough of him. Amen. Look at verse 8. He that loveth knoweth not God. Folks, that's a serious situation right there. There's a lot of people that think they know how to love, but they don't know what real love is all about. This is a real fervent, genuine love tonight, because he said, for God is love. So just in case you thought I might have forgot about the names of God, I didn't. His name is Elohim Avahe, A-V-A-H-A, which means the God who loves. Last week you learned about Jehovah Shalom, the God is there. I thank God he's there for you, church. But when he's there, he's loving on you when he's there. He's loving on you when you're going through that situation. He's loving on you when you're going through that circumstance. He's loving on you when you're going through that time. You don't know what you're going to do. You can count on God being there, and God don't ever change. Glory be to God. And his love is fervent. His love is real. And he's loving you all the way through that valley. Hallelujah. He's loving you all the way through your circumstance. He's loving you all the time. You're begging and pleading and crying. He's loving you all the way through it, church. When you say, Lord, I don't know how I'm going to make it. Lord, I don't see nothing change. Honey, he's loving you through it. Amen. Amen. Whoo, my Lord, I feel a Holy Ghost spirit tonight. He is Elohim of Ahi tonight to us. He said, in this was manifested. Thank God for the glory. That's the glory. See, the presence of God is everywhere. But I don't want just the omnipresence. I want the manifestation of God's presence. His presence may be in the barroom. His presence may be in the jail cell. But I want the manifest. I want the weightiness of His glory in my life, because that's what brings about change. That's what brings about renewal. That's what brings about a direction in our life tonight. So when we trust God, we believe in God. He said, in this was manifested the love of God toward who? Toward me. Towards you, glory to God. His love was manifested towards you. Why? Because that God sent His only begotten Son into the world that we might live through glory. Church, that's what love is right there. Yeah. That we might have life through Christ. He loved us tonight. He sent Christ to die for us tonight, His only Son, willingly. He said, no man taketh my life, but I willingly lay it down for you. That's love right there, folks. That is love in its finest tonight. And He said that we might, without Him, we didn't have life. We were dead, and a dead person don't feel the thing. I said a dead person don't feel a thing. I deal with death all the time, and believe me, they don't feel a thing. They don't bleed. Hello? There's no life there. But when you got the life, that's not God. When you got God living on the inside of you, folks, you're a living, breathing, being a new creation in Christ. And because you have a relationship with God, you know how to love Him. And because He put His love inside of you, you know how to love your neighbor. You know how to love people through this. And you know that God loves you. He said, herein is love. Not that we love God, but that He loved us. Thank God for that love. That's why we're saying this. We love Him because He first loved us tonight. We reciprocate that love back to Him, and we reciprocate that to others. Remember what He said? He said, when you've done it unto the least of these, you've done it to me. So how we love our neighbor is in response to how we love God. He said, if they're in a prison, we visit them. If they're naked, if they're poor, if they're blind, we go take care of them. We help provide that need tonight. And especially the last one, He said, he was a stranger, and I took him in. You'll catch that in a minute. You'll get it in a minute. So He says, but we love them. He said, herein is love. He said, this is what love is. Not that we love God, but that God loved us. God loved us. And He sent His Son to be the propitiation for our sins. He became the ultimate sacrifice, church. Without spot, without blemish, He became our sacrifice once and for all. The Bible says when he committed the sacrifice, He went and He sat down at the right hand of the Father. Amen. Thank God it was a done deal. Thank God there was no more death, no more dying for Him. It was a one time in His blood, and His love was enough for a lifetime for you and I. When we see this tonight, we're talking about divine affection. That's what love is a divine affection. It means that God is for you. God is for you. God is not against you. God is for you tonight. And watch this. God desires us to have whatever is best for you. We say, sometimes we think, well, the enemy's lied to us, and he gets to thinking, well, I don't really care about my desires. Oh, yes, he does. Because he is Elohim Evaha. He is the God of love. He's the God who loves, and God desires for you to be blessed, for you to have what is best for you. Amen. Don't listen to the devil tonight. The devil is a liar, and he's a thief, he's a murderer tonight, and quit listening to him. Amen. God desires you to have whatever is best for you. Yeah. Somebody say, he wants the best for me. He wants the best for me. Glory to God. When you're his favorite, yeah. Amen. God wants God. Let me tell you, how do you know that, Pastor? Who did God send? Did he give the leftovers? Did he? No, he gave the very best. And we are heirs of God and joint. Why will we think any different for you and I tonight? He loves us just as much as he loves his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, tonight. He loves us tonight. He desires for us to have what is best for us. What's it? And so if he desires for you to have what's best for you, then he must hate everything that is going to harm you. So what did he do? Sometimes we don't fully comprehend, or we don't fully ingest all this into the equation tonight. And we talk about the wrath of God, we talk about the judgment of God, and we get fearful and we get afraid and we say, oh no. But really what the point is tonight is God has wrath toward the sin that so doeth easily beset us tonight. God took vengeance and God took his wrath out upon sin, glory to God. And he loved the sinner. Hello? He said, when I was a sinner, it's when he died for me. He took his wrath, he took his judgment out upon sin. The Bible says that Jesus became sin who knew no sin. Christ took that sin. He took the wrath of God. He took the beatings of God. He took the stripes of God for you and I tonight. You understand that? He poured his wrath out, not upon us, but he poured his wrath out upon sin, that he might defeat sin. Hello? Remember, he said he broke the power of sin over our lives. Somebody shout tonight. That's the love of God. He took vengeance. He took his wrath upon the sin. My God, the only problem is now the sinner needs to quit sinning, because the power of sin's already been broken. We have a choice whether to sin, to do that or not, but Christ took his wrath against sin, and he defeated sin, didn't he? Yes, he did. Yes, he did. So therefore, it tells us that we have victory. We walk in him tonight, because if God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, and if God is our all in all, then he is love all the time. Then he is love all the time. So when we find this, we look in another Hebrew word, love. In the Hebrew, it means hesed. Hesed. It's a word that is used a lot. The word hesed. A lot of your Bible scholars will use this Hebrew word in their ministries, in their preachings. It's a popular word, hesed. It means God's unconditional love. God's unconditional love tonight. It means his love is compassionate. How many has experienced that compassionate love tonight in your life? I know you have, church. Because, my Lord, that's Holy Ghost powerful right there. How many knows that God's love tonight, it endures. When we don't, sometimes his love endures, and it gives us that persevering spirit inside of us tonight. And we talk about the hesed of love tonight. It means wrapping up in itself all of the positive attributes of God. Listen to that statement. It wraps up all the positive attributes of God. God's character, God's demeanor doesn't ever change. It never changes. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So if God is love tonight, then in through all of his attributes, which are love, God is love, through the covenant, through his faithfulness, through his mercy, thank God for that tonight, through his grace, through his kindness, through his loyalty, through his justice, and through his holiness tonight, God never changes. God never changes in any of that tonight. So we see this tonight, that God is love. So know that when you're going through the tribulation, I know that you're, number one, you are kept. You're kept how? By his love. You're kept so he can show his mercy. He can show his grace while he's keeping you from harm, while he's keeping you on the straight and narrow, while he's keeping you from the mouth of the lion, while he's keeping you. Number two, he is caring for you. He's caring for you. That's what love does. Love cares about you. That's the benevolence. That's the benevolence of love, as he cares for you, because, remember, he freely gave his life for you. That's benevolence of God. So number one, he keeps you. Number two, he cares for you. Number three tonight, he is watch over your life. The unseen hand has been watching over your life from day one. Amen. He is consistently and constantly, you have never left his sight. You've never been once out of his sight. Mary, do you remember that time I wrecked my van out there in Schneider? I was out on a way dark, wasn't dark road, it was a dirt road way out northwest of town, and it got real bad, rub board. And as I come up the corner, I lost control. My van went to and it rolled over, took out a fence and rolled over on top of that. But right before that happened, there was a Gaither song that was playing on the radio, and it says, his eye is watching over me. He said, he may be making rainbows or feeding the sparrow, but his eye is always over me. And I'm sitting there upside down in my van, and the seatbelt is on, and the song is still playing right on the radio. Sure, not a thing happened to me, not a sore, not by God, my God. He is consistently watching over because of his great love of compassion toward us. Oh, my Lord. Number four, he's always there. I said he's always there, church. Somebody get that in your spirit tonight. I said you may feel like you're alone. You may be in a crowded room of 300 people and you feel lonely, but I want to remind you tonight, you got a God who loves you, and you are never alone. You're never alone. You're never alone tonight. God's love is essential. Hello. I said, God's love is essential in your life tonight. Hallelujah. How many know that his love is wonderful? Woo! His love is shalalalamohokiyalalalaka. His love is wonderful tonight. His love is fabulous tonight. His love is extravagant. Glory be to God. Somebody bless his holy name tonight. His love tonight is a life-changing, and it brings life-changing implications to a person's life. It changes a heart. It changes a mind. It changes an attitude. It changes a mindset tonight. Because why? Because it is a divine passion of God's love towards you. It's divine love. It's not just filio. It is a kind of agape kind of love. He reads on here, verse 12. He said, no man has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God dwelleth in us. Oh, church, don't you feel it tonight? Don't you feel that agape kind of love resonating inside your love tonight? And you can express that love as a people now. And he says right here, he says, because God dwelleth in us, and his love is what? Perfected in us tonight. Hallelujah. You look at a world where there's hate. You look in a world where there's jealousy. You look in a world that's full of envy and full of confusion, and there's murders and there's rapings going on and there's thieving going on and there's drug abuses as never before. Folks, it's living in awful times. But I don't believe the church has ever been more mature and strong in our love. We're dependent upon this kind of love. Amen. We're dependent upon God to see us through this tonight. We're going to trust in him. You could probably read on a little bit further, verse 16, to say, God is love. God is love, and he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him. Now somebody say, God's living on the inside of me. I said, God is inside of me. Somebody shout tonight, God's inside of me. God, greater is he that is in me than he that's in the world tonight. My Lord, look what he said. Look what he said in Psalms 91. Glory be to God. Psalms 91. We know what it is tonight. When you're in trouble, you call, you dial up Psalms 91:1. Hello? You don't just call 911, you dial up Psalms 91:1. He said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Church, you can't find a safer place. You can't find a more confident place to abide. And my God, he lives inside of me. Glory to God. He dwells in that, and I dwell in him. Amen. Woo, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge. I will say of the Lord, he is my fortress. I will say, he is my God, and in him will I trust. Why? Because I'm trusting in my God tonight. I'm trusting in his love to carry me through. He says, verse 3, he shall deliver thee. Come on, somebody. You say, I don't know how I'm going to get out of this one. Oh, I tell you, you got a God that loves you, and he hates everything that's trying to harm you. He hates everything that's trying to hinder you. He hates everything that is against you tonight, church. Oh, my Lord. He said, he shall deliver from the snare of the fowler, and he shall deliver you from the noisome pestilence. Glory to God. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings thou shalt trust. His truth shall be thy shield and be thy buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. He said, a thousand shall fall at thy right side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh. Honey, that's a shouting ground right there. Woo! Hallelujah. Somebody shout. Just shout tonight. Makes you feel good. It makes you feel good. When you're doing laundry, just shout it out. Woo! Get that laundry. You come out of there in the name of Jesus. You shout it out, church. I love being Pentecostal, amen. There's no way. I couldn't even be a good Baptist. I got too much shout on the inside of me. My Lord. Look what he said. I'm trying to hurry here. Look, let's skip on down a little bit. Go down to verse 14. This is where I really want to go to anyway. Verse 14. Look at this. Here's the reciprocating love. Jesus flips the page. And God is answering now, responding back to the first 13 chapters. He says, because you have set your love upon me. David was expressing God's love toward him, but in verse 14, David reciprocates and responds back to God, and God has sent David, because you have set your love upon me, this is what I'm going to do for you now. He says, I will deliver him. Somebody shout right there. There's a deliverance in God's love in you tonight. He said, and I will set him on my Lord. Church, you're not beneath. You're not the tail. You're above tonight. Amen. My Lord. You've been set on high. You've been set in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I will set him on high because he's known my name. My Lord. Honey, I know his name. And his name is Elohim. Ahave tonight. Amen. Say that with me. Elohim. Ahave means God is love, the God who loves me. Jehovah Shammah, the God who loves me, is there with me. Hallelujah. Oh, my Lord, this doesn't make a backslid Lutheran want to shout tonight. He said in 15, he shall call upon me. When you call upon God, he said, I will answer you. You ought to write out beside it Jeremiah 33 and verse 3. Amen. Just write that out beside of it right there. Before he calls, I will answer him. Oh, my Lord. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him, and I will be with him in trouble. Hallelujah. I will deliver him. I will deliver you, my child. Not only will I set you on high, but I will honor you. God honors you tonight because you love him. Folks, there is a spirit about love that Tina Turner never understood. She never understood it. But for the born-again believer who walks with God, who talks with God, who knows with God, who's established in a relationship and a covenant with God, you begin to understand what love is all about. And he says, I will honor him with what? Long life. Long life. Long life. Will I satisfy him? That's what he's telling you. I will walk with you every step of your stage of your life, every age of your life, every age of your life. I'm going to walk with you, and I'm going to love you, and all the time I'm walking with you and keeping you and watching you and listening to you, I'm going to satisfy you. I don't know how we're going to make it. God don't change. We got to grow in that love. We got to mature our love and understand who he is tonight. With long life will I satisfy, and I will show him my salvation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will show him my salvation. I believe God wants to show you his salvation tonight. Amen. Let's skip down here. Go to 116. I'll try to wrap this thing up. Psalm 116, I love this chapter. Love this chapter. Oh, how I love the law of God. Psalm 116, verse 1. Psalms 116, verse 1. You need to write this down right here. Or mark it, highlight or something. This is you. This is personal. This is personal right here. This is one of those fill in the blanks. I love the Lord because. You need to draw a line out there and say, why do I love my Lord tonight? Why do I love my Jesus? Oh, can I count the ways? How can I count the ways? Do I love the Lord because of what He's done for me? Or do I love the Lord just because of who He is? Oh, come on, somebody. I want to love Him just for who He is. I want to love Him not for His hand, but I want to love Him because of His face tonight. Amen. I want to love Him because He loves me. I want to love Him that, yes, God has done multiple things for you and I, but I want to go back. Lord, I love You just because You love me. Because when we love God tonight, this is what we talk about, is this simple station right here. Because when we talk about the hesed of love tonight, it means enjoying who God is. Write that down. Enjoying who God is. Folks, if we don't enjoy Jesus, we might want to question our walk. That's right. Enjoy His presence. Enjoy just being with God. Woo, my Lord. Just enjoy being with Him and walking with Him and talking with Him and just visiting with God and fellowshipping with God. Just enjoying Jesus. Hello? Just enjoy Jesus. Number two. This right here. Not only just enjoy Him, but be satisfied with Him. Just be satisfied with Him. You know, the man, he said, he found a field that had a treasure in that field. He went and sold all he had to buy that field because that field had a treasure and something he wanted. He was satisfied with just that one piece of property. Hello. Just like we read in the story of Ruth and Naomi the other night, he said, you don't need to go to another field. I'll take care of you right here in my field. Come on, somebody. We're in the right place at the right time being loved by the right God tonight. Amen. Who is showing grace and compassion and mercy for you and I tonight. And he said, I want you just to enjoy me. Number two, I want you to be satisfied with me. Don't be looking somewhere else. Don't be looking somewhere else. Just be satisfied with me because that's when God is most glorified, isn't it? That's when God is most honored. That's when God is most blessed. It's when we just want to spend time with Him. See, God's all about this big R word. R word. Relationship. That's it. When it boils down to the end of the day, it's all about relationship. So the Psalm 16 verse 1 says, I love the Lord because He's heard my voice. You could go in here. As a matter of fact, there's 17 reasons here the psalmist wrote down. He penned 17 reasons for himself. I'm sure we come up with 17 ourselves, huh? Number one, because He heard my prayers. Number one, He listens to me. So if God listens to us, if we reciprocate that love, we need to listen to Him. Amen. I've got to hurry. I got 2 minutes. I want to be done by 8:00. 2 minutes. Verse 2. He inclined His ear unto me. Second reason. Verse 5. I love the Lord because He's been gracious. He's been gracious to me, church. Number 5. I love Him because He's been righteous to me. He showed His righteousness to me. Gave His righteousness to me. I love the Lord because He's been merciful to me. Hallelujah. He's been merciful to me. Verse 6. Because He preserveth the simple. Honey, I've been preserved tonight. Number 6. He said, He helped me. How many times have God helped you, church? I love Him because He's helped me. Verse 7. Because He had dealt bountifully with me. Verse 8. He delivered my soul from death. Come on, somebody. He gave me eternal life. He said, mine eyes from tears. He's kept my feet from falling. He's always watching. He's always there for us. Verse 12, I love the Lord because of all his benefits. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love the Lord because of all of his benefits. Hallelujah. Oh, my Lord. Verse 16. Because he loosed my bonds. Church, he set you free. I said he set you free tonight. His love. It all goes back to that love relationship with God. He's done so much for you and I. So he is Elohim Avahe. My Lord, the God who loves you tonight, my Lord, we can honor him by obeying all his commands, keeping his commandments tonight, being thankful. Somebody say this, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let's lift your hand. I'm going to pause on that note right there. Father, we love you, my Lord. Father, we want to be a thankful, grateful people tonight. Lord, we're truly debtors, Lord, to your inexhaustible love tonight, Lord, that is full of compassion. Lord, you've been merciful. Lord, you've been kind. Lord, you've honored us. My Lord God, you've showed us give us your righteousness tonight, Lord. And Father, we thank you for the word of God, Lord, that tells me so. Lord, we thank you for the word of truth tonight, Lord, that enlightens me, Lord, that strengthens me, that keeps me from falling tonight, my Lord. Father, your rod and your staff, Lord, they comfort me tonight, Lord. There's so many blessings undeserving what they are, Lord. Father, I'm dependent upon you tonight, Lord. I say tonight, Lord, you're enough. Lord, you're enough tonight, Lord. Lord, I'm satisfied. I'm not looking for another God. Lord, I'm not looking for another idol. Lord, you're more than enough tonight, Lord. Father, I enjoy you. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that we're satisfied, Lord, with serving you and living with you for eternity, Lord. Because truly you are all in all the time. You're all in all the time in my life, Lord. Lord, you've never abandoned me. Lord, you've never left me. Lord, you've never left me alone, Lord. Father, your love is always right there, Lord. Father, you've loved us as you told the Israelites. Lord, you said, I love you as the apple of my eye. Hallelujah. Lord, you set your love upon them, oh God. Father, and we pray tonight, God, we set our love upon you. Father, my Lord, I thank you, Father, for the Holy Ghost tonight. Thank you for the Holy Ghost tonight, Lord, that's empowered, Lord, our lives and given us life. Life in this world, Lord, and in the life to come. Lord, that eternal life. Lord, that eternal salvation. Lord, we love you for it in the precious, precious, precious name of Jesus tonight. Hallelujah. Let's stand to our feet tonight and just grab your neighbor by the hand tonight. Grab your neighbor by the hand, if you would, tonight. There's a little song that goes like this tonight. Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Sing it out. Yeah. Woo. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, shalalamura kisha na 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 kai. Bless you, Lord. The Bible tells me so. I want you to pray for your neighbor right now, church. I want you to pray God's love all over the others, smother in it. Smother them in God's love tonight. Smother, my Lord, just smother them in love. Smother them with kindness tonight. Just pray God's love all over them tonight, because God's love never fails. God's love never fails. Now abideth faith, hope, and love, and the greatest of these is love tonight. I show you a greater gift than the love of God. Hallelujah. The greatest gift we can have are labors of love tonight. Father, we thank you tonight, Lord. We're ambassadors, Lord, of your love tonight, Lord. Father, we thank you. Lord, you sent your love to be bestowed upon your children, Lord. Father, I pray, let it dwell, Lord, and abide and surround and cover them, Lord. Cover them in your love tonight, Lord. Father, we thank you that there's nothing, Lord, there's nothing, Lord, that can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Father, my Lord, I love you for it tonight. God, I love you for it. I love you for it. I love you for it, Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord tonight, Lord. No weapon formed against these people shall prosper. In Jesus' name, Lord, lift them up on high. Honor them, Lord. Bless them. Deliver them tonight, Lord. Show them your salvation. Lord, we love you for it, and we give you all the praise in Jesus' holy name. And everybody said amen tonight. Amen, amen. Lord, bless you. Lord, love you tonight. Josh, is it all good out there? Hey, we're all good out there. Out front, go out there, have some cookies and punches for a few minutes tonight, and just get some fellowship and just love people and visit for a few moments before you leave tonight, and just thank God for his goodness tonight. Give somebody a hug. Tell them you love them.